power. Get your hands dirty yet, Laura?
Not yet, but right now we're talking about fashion. This is a very interesting setup that they got here. I've got Will Allen joining me right now. What is going on? We got plants up here. We got fish down here. We got mushroom trunk things over here. What is going on?
Well, this is a very innovative system here. Actually, the plants filter out the waste that the fish give off. This is a closed-loop system, a water conservation system that a lot of people around the world want to use today. And this is something that we came up with a few years ago that's become very popular in aquaponics. We're working with the Great Lakes Institute, Fred Binkowski, who I think is the foremost person that does this pinfish stuff in the country. Mm-hmm. And we're doing some research on how to grow different types of fish, especially the lake perch. Mm-hmm. I mean, if we had a million pounds of fillets today, we'd have them sold by tonight.
Oh, wow.
Because the Great Lakes have pretty much been shut down, so it's a tremendous opportunity for many folks, and this has become very popular. So what we have here is tilapia. We're going to show you.
Look at that. Whoa, get a little bit of a shower
these
here.
Systems, these 750-gallon systems hold about 700 fish, and these fish taste so much better than what's coming out of China, South America, or growing anywhere else because they're fresh. They're don't have any contaminants in the meat. Mm-hmm. They're just delicious, and people can come here and get them, and we have these at some of the restaurants around town as well.
Another thing that's interesting about this is you're filtering this water all the way through, and you only have to refill the water, what, every three, 4 weeks?
About once every 3 weeks or so, we'll add makeup water as evaporation takes place. But we also have another fish that we got from the Great Lakes Institute.
Look at this. We're doing
some research.
Whoa.
This is a pacu. Uh-huh. It's a Brazilian fish. It's in the piranha family. This particular fish gets up to 60 pounds.
Wow.
This one weighs about 15 pounds.
So it's got some growing to do.
It's got a lot of meat on it, and a lot of the chefs are waiting for us to start growing this fish. But we're doing a little research to see the amount of space you need to grow these fish out in a controlled environment like we have here.
And they are vegetarians, actually, too, and they have people teeth, which is really
Yeah, they have pretty interesting teeth. These come from Brazil, the Amazon, the Amazonian fish. They're related to, like I said before, piranha. Mm-hmm. And they eat nuts and fruit, so they fix omega-3 in their meat, just like tuna. And so this is going to be a very healthy piece for cities, folks that are living in cities and all areas to be able to grow the protein that we need, the healthy protein that we need.
Very interesting. Well, we'll be still hanging out here all morning long, but for now, Brittany, we're going to throw it to you.
Let's have a fish fry later. I could eat fish every day. A random fact about me? Maybe. Let's check out a time.